Thank you very much, comrades. To start with, we are very much disappointed in the manner in which the so-called bogus dialog meeting was called. It was fraud. Me and him, we were, and other, you know, progressive youths from other political parties, different political parties, were not called. It was a meeting of carefully, mark the word, carefully selected youths, probably PF aligned, because they were only 50. They were carefully selected. They didn't extend an invitation to various stakeholders, because we've got youths in DP, youths in NDC, youths in UPND, youths in various organizations that were also interested in the proceedings. Secondly, the meeting was called on short notice, which made other youths not to attend.
Because the minister said it is urgent.
No, they needed to notify everybody. Three, it was not all inclusive, because it didn't have representation from all the other provinces. The other issue is the venue.
Yes. What if they say that this is the start of a series of meetings across the country?
No, the first meeting was supposed to be, the first cut is the deepest, comrade. The first cut is the deepest, because we needed to have the first cut where it is, there's a total representation from different. Now, the other issue is that, as we were not called, but we decided, me and him, to go there, storm that meeting without invitation, because we had a message to go and deliver to the Minister of Youth. And we did. We went there without invitation.
So you delivered the message that you wanted to deliver on the 22nd?
What we did, we entered there, stormed the meeting, told the minister that the meeting was flawed. And two, we told the minister that the agenda was not supposed to be set by government. The agenda was supposed to be set by young people. Because it is us who are aggrieved as young people. It is us, the youths, who are disgruntled. We needed to set the agenda on the pertinent issues that we need to discuss, and not government. Guess what? The agenda was given out, and none of the things that we are advocating for as young people was on the agenda. Young people want us to, young people, we the youths, we want government to address the issue of the gold scandal. We want government to address the issue of butane. We want government to address the issue of corruption, freedom of expression, bad governance, and other issues which were not brought out in the meeting. I rose at that meeting and spoke to the minister. I faced him and told him to say, this meeting is fraud because you have set the agenda. And we walked out of that meeting after we delivered the message, and we delivered the message
before he even responded to you. Did he respond to you?
We, by the time I was pointed at to speak, comrade, the video is there all over on social media. The time I was pointed at to speak, the moment I just said, my name's Amatomola, I'm from the United Party for National Development, you could hear in the video, I was being curtailed to speak. The meeting, the way it was, we stayed for 2 hours, from 14 hours to 16 hours. None of the young people had spoken. The people that were speaking at the youth dialogue, they brought PF-aligned businessmen who were telling us about their success stories. They spoke for 2 hours. The only chance that was given to young people to speak, it was about 30 minutes. And even in that minute, in that 30 minutes, the minister was seen curtailing certain youths from speaking. There's a certain youth from Central Province who was interjected and lambasted by the minister. Even me, I'm on record, the video is there. Lambasted.
Let's just speak this call. Hello? Hello?
How are you, my brother?
Ngumbwa.